We got a long one. Get a snack because today I'm going to be sharing with you the number one best product from every brand at Sephora that I've tried. So this is an updated one. I did one about a year and a half ago and some things have definitely changed. There's some different brands, some new additions, some brands are no longer at Sephora. That's some tea. And you know, I think it's interesting. I was just watching that video that I did and there's a few brands where this top product is still the same, but there's some brands that I have replaced out. So basically the thought process behind this is if you were shopping at Sephora and you're like, I want to try this brand, what do I need to try from this brand? This is the product that I would recommend from that brand to you. It was definitely a little trickier with some brands more than others, but today I have 56 brands that I'm going to be sharing the best product with you. So let's just go ahead and get into it, starting off with ABH. Oh, by the way, if you notice any brands missing, it might be because, you know what, I just don't have a product that I want to share, or I might not feel as though I have enough experience in the brand. But let's get started. ABH, their best product. This one is changing from the last video, but I just think one of their best tried and true products that really is so versatile and I think so many people would love would be the Soft Glam palette. Now, first of all, it's a beautiful, buttery, pigmented, easy to use formula from ABH, but also it is so versatile. You can see the palette ranges from light depth all the way to deep dark black. We have warm tones, we have neutral tones, there's some mauve-y tones in here. There's a lot of versatility within this one palette, and I think it's going to work for so many ranges of skin tones and types of people. So yeah, I think that this is their best product at the moment. Armani Beauty, we're gonna stick with the tried and true classic. This is their Luminous Silk Foundation. This is a product that has kept them on the map, put them on the map. Everybody loves this foundation. Okay, maybe I'm exaggerating, but I am one of those that loves this foundation because it's the perfect in the middle foundation. Not too much coverage, not too little coverage, not too glowy, not too matte, not too dry, not too glowy, not too oily. Just the perfect foundation, and it's extremely long wear. This has been a favorite of mine throughout the years, and it still is, in my opinion, their number one product. I think I did a concealer last time, but I'm back on this. This one has been a favorite for years. Bare Minerals. So I've tried a few more products this year. You know, they have some hits in the brand, they have some misses as well, but one that is a product that I'm constantly reaching for from them are their bronzers. I think that these are so beautiful on the cheek. They do have a shimmer to them, so if you don't like shimmer, I don't think you're gonna like this product, but it's a very rich consistency, a rich color, and a really beautiful sheen to the skin that doesn't emphasize texture too much. It's quite unique, and I just love this rich, buttery feel that it has. So for me, this is their best product. Beauty Blender. I almost didn't include this brand, but they have tried their hand at makeup, and honestly, I think they've failed their hand. My mother's calling. They've tried their hand at makeup, and honestly, I think they failed their hand at makeup because their best product, go figure, from Beauty Blender is the Beauty Blender, and I still love the Beauty Blender to this day. I don't think you need to spend $20 on any sort of beauty sponge. There are really great options out there, but I will say every time I use a real tried and true beauty blender, it's just the best. It still is the best sponge. There's a lot of amazing sponges out there that make $20 definitely not worth the price, but like if you can get it in like a set or like a gift set, I'm like, you know, I certainly enjoy my time with it. Let's move on to Benefit. Benefit is known for their brows, and for good reason. I think that they have the best brow gel on the market. Well, there's some competition now, but still, the Benefit 24-Hour Brow Setter has been for a long time the best brow product on the market, especially when I really learned how to use the applicator. So this one is going to set and lay your brows all day. Where you set them is where they stay. They're gonna be like that all day. I love the applicator because I feel like it really separates each of the brow hairs exactly to where you want them to go, giving them a more full look. So I've talked about this one a lot. It's one of my favorites. If you gotta get anything from Benefit, it has to be this. Bobbi Brown. Okay, so I've discovered a few new products from them this year. You know, over the years, I've used a lot of their foundations. They were one of my first luxury foundations that I ever had for myself. But what I've been loving from the brand this year are their Pot Rouges. And these are a true cream formula for the cheeks and the lips. There's not a lot of cream formulas that I like literally for both the cheeks and the lips. This is one of the very few, and it's extremely hydrating, especially on the cheeks. I have this one in the shade Powder Pink. It blends out like butter on the cheeks, but looks really dewy and moisturized, and then it's also a beautiful product on the lips. This year has definitely been my favorite product from the brand. I think it's a unique cream formula, which is interesting because how unique can like a cream blush be? For some reason, I really feel like it's just a creme de la creme cream blush and lip formulation. One of the very few that can do both. Cali Ray is a smaller brand at Sephora, and I feel like not a lot of people talk about their skin wellness diffusing tint. It's basically just a lightweight foundation, or I guess more so like tinted foundation. It's really watery. It's definitely unique, but I love the way that it looks on the skin. They also have really great glosses in the line. It's a small line. I think it's underrated because most of the products from the brand I've tried are really amazing. This is one of my favorite products in the summer. So if you're looking for a new skin tint in the summer, definitely look towards Cali Ray. Charlotte Tilbury. This one is not changing from last year's. Charlotte Tilbury has the best lipstick formula ever, in my opinion. And along with that, she also has an amazing color range. Did you guys see she's coming out with a new range of lipsticks? I'm so excited for that one. But the ultimate lipstick, in my opinion, in this entire makeup universe is her Kissing formula. It's just a really creamy, moisturizing lip formula that still has longevity. I know the moisturizing lip formula right now is very popular, but this one is unique because it's thick, but it's still creamy, it's still soft, it smooths over the lines of the lips, and it lasts a really long time. There's a lot of opacity in the colors, and like I said, she has the best color range. One of my all-time favorites is Nude Kate. If you're into a cooler toned nude shade, pair this with Iconic Nude Lip Liner from Charlotte Tilbury. You have the perfect nude lip if you're near my skin tone. But yeah, Charlotte Tilbury has so many amazing, unique products that I could do a whole video pointing out to you. But if you had to pick one, I think a lipstick is worth the splurge from her. Moving on to one of my favorite makeup artists, Danessa Myricks. Her skin primer is one of my favorites. This is the Yummy Skin Glow Serum, and I love it because it does feel very hydrating on the skin, but it gives the prettiest glow that is great underneath makeup, but it also looks so pretty on its own, and I don't say that about a lot of primers, especially when they do have that glowy element, because I find sometimes that that can emphasize fine lines, but I don't find that to be the case with this. And then, of course, it's very, very hydrating, but it's quick to sink into the skin, and it smells delicious. Delicious, like cantaloupes. It's my favorite product in their line. Dior Airflash foundation, off the list, no longer there. So I had to go for what was second best from the brand, which their Forever foundation line in general is one of my favorites. They never fail me with their foundations. Dior in general has amazing foundations, but the Forever line is my second favorite, and I'm including just the original matte Forever and then the Skin Glow foundation as well. That one's more glowy, but I do like the matte one for all night wear, evenings, events, dinners. Especially with me living in Miami, it's really, really hot. I get really sweaty. A matte foundation like this is phenomenal for that. It looks really smooth on the skin and it lasts all night. It gives that perfect look, extremely photogenic. This is an amazing foundation. If I can't have the Airflash, I'll take that one. The next one is actually a very similar description to that of the Dior. So this is from Estee Lauder, where I actually haven't tried too many products from, but this foundation is so classic. You can't go in any other direction. It is the double wear foundation. This one is even longer wearing than the Dior. The kind of difference here, I think the Dior is more smoothing than the Estee Lauder, but the Estee Lauder wears the longest. If you're going to Disney, baby, and you want to wear some makeup, you're walking, you're sweaty, this is a foundation that is going to last through it all, this is the longest wearing foundation on the market that doesn't look awful on the skin. So if you're going Estee Lauder, double wear is a classic. Fenty Beauty, I'm not changing from what I said last year. And I know if you watch my videos, you would think that I would say the lip glosses. But you know what? There's so many brands that have mastered lip glosses that you don't need to go towards the Fenty route. What Fenty has that is a unique formula that is better than what you can find on the market are these concealers. And sometimes I forget about them because they are a lighter coverage product, so I don't reach for them a ton. But these are the Bright Fix Eye Brighteners, and not enough people talk about these. This is the most creaseless concealer I have ever used. And normally, I preach it's okay to have some creasing on your under eyes because there are literally creases there, but this defies the laws of gravity. When I was a makeup artist and I would wear my mask, I'd put a little bit of this on the under eyes and nothing else, and it wouldn't crease, but it would give me that eye-opening effect. So it does have a lighter coverage, however, it does kind of color correct the areas, and it's not going to crease. So if you are somebody who wears lighter makeup all day long, this is a product you need to go for. I truly have never come across a concealer that does what this does in terms of under eye creasing, aka not at all, no creasing. Next one, I think this is a new brand added to the list, Freck Beauty, originally known for their freckle thing, which I actually just used on Tuesday's video where I tried Alex Earle's makeup routine. Personally, well, I do think it's the best type of product for those fake freckles. I'm not a fan of that. What I am a fan of from their brand, however, is their Rich Pitch Protect Prime Serum. This is really interesting because it does have that snail mucin in it, So that's what you see with it kind of coming stringy. However, you know, if you can get that over that fun part of it, it actually is a really nice hydrating and sticky primer, which is going to help makeup last longer, but also sit prettier because it hydrates the skin. It's an awesome primer. It really does a nice job. Givenchy. I'm not super experienced in Givenchy, but I have definitely tried more from the brand than I ever had this last year. And game changer right here, the Givenchy Prism Libre Loose Setting Powder. I have mine in the rose shade. This is such a lightweight and super duper blurring, pore perfecting powder, extremely competitive with my Huda Beauty. The difference is, I would say this has a little bit more of a luminosity to it. So if you have dry skin, I would recommend to go for the Givenchy over the Huda Beauty. So yeah, this is one of the best, most blurring powders on the market. It's worth every penny. Glossier, I have a lot of products from them that I really, really enjoy, but generally speaking, I think their best product is the Stretch Concealer. It's such a hydrating concealer. It has quite full coverage, but it blends like butter into the skin. It's very, very easy to use. Yeah, I think it's great for teenagers because it does have that glowy look to it, but it's not too full coverage, and you know, for acne, I think this is one of the best concealers for spot concealing. And the way that they describe it as a stretch concealer is so the truth. It's such a good name because it does seem like the way that the concealer blends, it's almost stretching over the skin. From Gucci Beauty, this one is a hard one. Like, I don't know how confident I am in this choice, but of late, this is the number one Gucci Beauty product for me. It's their concealer. It has like almost a soft powder dry down. So I've been loving this for no makeup, makeup days, 5 minute makeup days. I believe I use this in my 5 minute makeup routine because I don't need to set it. It just gives a nice light evening coverage over the areas that I need it to. And it's beautiful blended over the cheek where I have some redness. It looks beautiful all over the face. It's a pricey product, but I really love this concealer and I've heard great things about this on mature skin as well. Give by Gwen Stefani randomly has the best eye pencils on the market. In particular, today I used the shade Hopscotch, which is kind of a shimmery light brown, but I've dealt with a couple other colors from this line, and I find that they apply so creamy, but then when they set, they're set and they are not going anywhere. So I love that about a pencil when it can be really creamy on application, but has a little bit of time to be smudged out and played around with. But then when it sets, like, it does what we want it to do and not move. And I think that's what Give has done best in their line. House Labs. Everybody, including myself, is talking about the foundation. However, I still think the best product in her line are the Bio Radiant Gel Powder Highlights. These are a powder highlight, but they are kind of a baked gelée kind of formula, so you're not going to get a lot of fallout from these. And the colors that she has are some of the prettiest line of highlighter colors I've ever seen. There's actually a lot of unique shades, and it's a very thin formula. I find that I like a highlighter that's really slick and thin because I feel like it looks more natural and has an easier blend onto the face. So I think that House Labs has a phenomenal highlighter formulation, and they look even better on the eyes too. You get so much product. I think not that they are underrated, but they are not talked about as much as they should be. They're overshadowed by products that I think these are better than. Hourglass. I'm not gonna go over this too much because you already know if they have the ambient lighting palettes, you need it. It's a combination of all of their best powder formulas. Truly, any Hourglass powder that you can get your hands on is going to be game-changing. The palettes are the best because you get a bronzer, a finishing powder, blushes, and highlights most of the time. If you're looking for an individual, they do have the best blushes. So an ambient blush is where I would start off if you're going individual. But why do that when you can get a palette? I saw that they didn't have any on the Sephora website right now, but they'll come around eventually. I did link to a blush, but hold off or order from the Hourglass website because these are the best powders on the market. Don't even try anything else. They do have a lot of other amazing products, but the powders are unbeatable. There's not a brand that has been able to replicate what Hourglass has done with their powders. Huda Beauty, you saw I've already talked about it. They do have the best setting powder in the game, if you ask me, competitive with Givenchy. This is their Easy Bake Loose Setting Powder. I have mine in three different colors. That's how much I love it. It's perfection. Like, it literally makes your skin look like perfection. Your pores will be gone with this, and it's also gonna last all night. If you have oily skin, this is the way to go. So the way I describe it, Givenchy and Huda Beauty on even playing fields as the best powders on the market. Givenchy for more dry skin days, Huda Beauty for oily skin days, or for like evenings where I need it to be set for even longer and really handle oil and sweat a little bit more on the heavy duty side, but it gives you perfect skin. That's that. Iconic London, a brand that I don't have a ton of experience with, but I find them to be an underrated brand because they've launched a lot of great innovative products. But their best product, which was back in the day one of their most viral products, is their Illuminator. And I have to say, it still is to this day one of the best liquid luminizers on the market. And this is coming from somebody who literally hates liquid luminizers. This is the only one, or one of the very few in the market, that I can get down with. So this still remains the best product from the brand. Ilia. They have a lot of really nice products, but lately the most versatile product that I've loved is their Super Serum Skin Tint, which I do believe is quite viral, but I don't use it in the way that a lot of people use it. So I actually use this to mix with other foundations. It's extremely thin and really, really hydrating. So if I have a foundation that's really dry or cakey looking on my skin, I will mix this in and immediately it adds instant hydration to that formulation. Or if I am using a foundation stick that's a little bit stiff, I will blend this on my face with that foundation stick and the foundation stick will blend with ease. I think this is just a handy product to have to help you out with your routine and other products. For me, it's a bit oily on its own, but it's such a superhero product that has helped me with so many other products that I have to have one of these in my collection at all times. Okay, I do not currently have the product that I picked from It Cosmetics simply because, you know, I do have to rotate things through as they get old. I can't repurchase everything to have everything all at once, but I would eventually like to repurchase their It Cosmetics CC cream. This really is just one of the best everyday products that you can use on the skin. I have sensitive skin and my skin really loves it because it's really hydrating, but it evens everything out. It looks really smooth, like I said, very hydrating on the skin. Just a great everyday foundation for so many different skin types. They don't have an overwhelming shade range as well. So the shade, since it's not full coverage, you can get away with wearing a few different shades. So I think that that also makes it friendly for a lot of people who aren't as obsessed with makeup as I am. So it's just great for the general public. So that's going to be my pick for It Cosmetics. I don't have it currently because I just don't want to have too much in my collection. I don't think I'm proving myself very well by saying that, but I had it at some point for many, many years, but I did eventually have to declutter it, but love that. Kaja. So Kaja randomly has an amazing eyeshadow formula. So these are their beauty bento trios. They have a wide range of shades in the line. So basically it's just this tiny little bento box inspired packaging. In the top layer you have an eyelid shade. It even has a mirror, and it depends on which ones you get, but normally there's like a lid shade, a mid-tone shade, and an outer corner shade. These are luxury formula. The formula is really buttery, very easy to blend, and it's a great way to not have to think too hard about what look you're going to create. And I love the colors that they have. This has always been my favorite product from the brand. From Kosas, randomly, like, Kosas is not known for their eyebrow products, but in my opinion, they have the best eyebrow pencils at Sephora, pretty much. I pulled the Brow Pop because it's the one that I've used the longest. However, they did just launch like a micro Brow Pop, which is a very, very teeny tiny eyebrow pencil. That one is also great. I love these because they aren't too wet or creamy of a formula. I like my brow pencils a little bit dry, and I just feel like Kosas, they know what I like. They have the same preferences that I do when it comes to a brow formulation. I like mine to almost be powdery so that I can blend it out like an eyeshadow. And Kosas fulfills that. They also have a great color for me that I enjoy. And you can get like a harder press, a more pigmented look if you press harder, or if you go softer, you can get a lighter kind of wash of color with this. So yeah, Kosas randomly has some of my favorite brow pencils. So those are my favorite products from them. KVD, this one's going to be shocking because even after I had tried this product, I didn't think it would actually end up being my favorite product from the brand. And I don't think a lot of people love this foundation quite like I do, but this is their Good Apple Full Coverage Foundation. I stinking love this. I can see why people don't like it because it can be heavy and it can be hard to blend. I do find that sometimes it can dry, so you have to work fast with this. However, every single time I wear this foundation, I'm having an amazing skin day. It's the foundation I'm wearing today. When I wear this, my skin looks even and it looks smooth. It is the oddest thing how much I love this foundation. So I honestly do not like applying this foundation, but when I want to look smooth, perfected, I want full coverage, I always have a good makeup day with this foundation. And when I was looking at the KVD product list, I was like, I can't believe I'm saying this, but this is my favorite product from them. It really is. Okay, La Mer. If you watch my recent declutter, mine had gotten a bit old, so I am going to repurchase it. But their Soft Fluid Foundation is one of the best foundations on the market. It also happens to be one of the most expensive, hence why I haven't run out to get it very quickly. But it gives the most soft look to the face. You have to try it to know what I'm talking about. But just like the KVD, but in a different way, every time I wear that foundation, my skin looks amazing. It looks smooth. It looks soft. It wears a long time. It's great for events. I mean, the La Mer cosmetic range, it's very minimal, honestly, but that foundation, whew, it's so good. Laura Mercier. Their name is in a lot of people's mouths right now if you're familiar with the industry, but I swear, they have the best powder blushes, and I feel like they can get a little lost in the sauce because there are so many amazing blush formulas out there, but this is just a good, tried and true blush formula that does what it's supposed to do. It's not too shimmery, not too flat, gives the perfect level of pigmentation, easy to blend, and then a really great wearable color range as well. Here's just a couple colors. Today I used Fresco to set over the blush that I was wearing, but every time I use this blush formula, I'm just like, dang. This is a good blush, and this is easily the most used product from the brand, and it doesn't get enough attention. The colors that they have make so much sense for everyday life. I'm telling you, if you pick up a couple colors from this brand, you will reach for them without thinking about it because the colors are so wearable, versatile. They'll go with any look, and you don't have to think too hard about how you're going to apply it with what you're going to apply it. You're just gonna grab it and put it on and be happy. Flawless. It's giving me this glow on my lips. I think that their Forget the Filler Lip Plumping Line Smoothing Glosses are delightful, delicious, and so okay, so they don't have a ton of colors, so they are expanding their range. It's a thicker formula, so it took a little bit for me to get used to it. And to be honest, it's a little sticky. Not in a bad way, but in a good way, in that it's going to last forever on the lips. And they call it Forget the Filler because it's a line smoothing lip plumping gloss. And they're able to do that because it is going to smooth over the lines of the lips. And then it also has a little bit of a plumping effect. You can feel it ever so slightly on the lips. And then also it's just so extremely glossy that the light's gonna poo. It's not gonna poo. It like boo, like bounce. Bounce off of that glow. It's their best product. LYS Beauty, I think that they have a phenomenal foundation. Now, they've really expanded their range recently, and I feel like they've launched a lot of good products. But still, when I think of LYS, I think of their Triple Fix Foundation. It's just a great everyday foundation. It feels really lightweight on the skin. It has a good medium coverage, and it wears not, it's not like the longest wearing foundation, but it feels good when you wear it. I feel like it was the dumbest description ever, but it's very comfortable on the skin. It's has like a little bit of a hydration factor to it. I don't know. I like this foundation. It's not the best foundation in the world, but I do think it's the best product from the brand. Makeup Forever. Honestly, it feels criminal to only mention one product because they have so many good products in their line. However, there is only one powder foundation I'm mentioning in this video, and it's this one because Makeup Forever creates the best powder foundation. This is the HD Skin Matte Velvet, and I know powder foundations can seem intimidating, but I'm telling you, you apply this and then it almost becomes not like a liquid foundation, but it looks like a liquid foundation. Powder foundations are phenomenal for people who just want to do their makeup quickly because it's so easy to just brush it over the face, or for people with oily skin. This almost kind of fuses with the natural oils of your skin to make it look really soft and creamy. I'm telling you, don't knock it till you try it. Makeup Forever has the best powder foundation. If you're going Makeup by Mario, you need to go for their cream bronzers. I couldn't pick just one. I'm talking about two of his formulas. If you're looking for something more heavy duty, more sculpting, I have it on this side of my face, go for the Soft Sculpt Shaping Stick. These are for my friends that like to go out, that like to get snatched, because these have a little bit more pigment, they're a little bit more robust. However, if you're more into natural makeup, you have to try. These are such a unique formula. The Soft Sculpt Transforming Skin Enhancers. So these are a bronzer that is very sheer, a lot more subtle. It's almost better if you go for that no makeup makeup look, or you want to pair it with a skin tint. It's just an overall softer look to the face, but it still gives that sculpt. So I would say that this is the most unique of the two bronzers, which might be the reason that you want to pick this one up. The tone of the Soft Sculpt Shaping Sticks are amazing for contouring, at least for me. So if you're going Makeup by Mario, go cream bronzer slash contour situation. They have the best. Melt Cosmetics, I'm sticking with the Gemini palette. In my opinion, by far what Melt does best is eyeshadows, and I feel like this is the perfect embodiment of the brand. It's grungy, but it's still wearable, it's still approachable, it's still one of the more unique, fun color stories on the market, but I still don't feel intimidated by this. It's a good representation of a good formula that Melt can do. I don't know, I just, for some reason, when I think of Melt, I think of this palette, and I don't think you're gonna be disappointed. Merit. I see Merit a lot on social media. If you ask me, their best product that not enough people talk about are their signature lipsticks. The packaging is randomly extremely luxury. Like, this lines up with all of my most expensive lipsticks, but it's not quite that expensive. And they also have a really buttery, smooth lipstick formula. It just applies to the lips like cream, and the color range is also really nice. Honestly, the only way I can describe this is it's like a luxury lipstick formulation. It's by far, in my opinion, their best product. Milk Makeup, this one was tough. I feel like they have a lot of good products. But for me, what they have done best is their Future Fluid Cream Concealer. This has a really lightweight feel and a soft silk finish and blend on the skin. It looks really natural, but of course gives that medium coverage. It's almost as like milk on the under eye. Is the best way that I can describe it. It's honestly one of my favorite concealers. It doesn't look too heavy. So yeah, I mean, I think that this is one of their best products. Well, the best product in their line. I'm not gonna sugarcoat it. It is. Natasha Denona, we're staying with the Glam palette. This is still my favorite. I feel like I know cool tones are more popular, but still, cool tones are not in the same abundance that warm tones are. And I just feel like Natasha has nailed it down with this palette. She, of course, since this has launched a lot of other great palettes, but this one still remains my favorite because there still is some warm elements in here in case you want to mix it up a little bit. It's the best value palette that you can get from the brand. And noting how expensive her products are, because this is a lesser amount of formula for a lesser price, which I think is the way to go, because you still get a lot of different colors. There's a great range in depths here. You have a great range in finishes as well. In my opinion, still her best palette and definitely one of the ones that you need to go for. NARS, another one where I'm like, how can I only pick one? But one of their most unique products that's just a staple in anybody's makeup routine should be the Soft Matte Complete Concealer. This is amazing. If you have a big, red, honky, shiny zit, this will cover it. The matte finish does a really nice job in diminishing that glow that sometimes zits can have, and it blends out almost like a soft powder. It's different from the Glossier. The Glossier I also recommend for acne, but Glossier is more hydrating. This one is more like a soft powder, so I think this is even better for acne coverage. It's pretty on the under eyes. I do prefer the Glossier on the under eyes versus this one more so on the face. They're both really great, but this one's a little bit more of a soft matte. Just depending on what kind of look you're going for, what base you have, one of the best pot concealers on the market as well. Nude Sticks. Okay, we are still, after all this time, in the era of cream blushes, and the more that have come out, the more that I've tried, the more that I've fallen back into using my Nude Sticks cream blushes. Now, they don't seem as new and exciting if you ask me. The packaging can read a little outdated, and also the formula feels a little bit drier, a little bit more boring, but now I've discovered, I think that's why I like this. This has less of an emollient feel, a little bit more of a powdery feel, but guess what? It will last. It doesn't slip and slide on the face. It's a much more reliable formulation, longevity-wise, and they have since expanded their range, expanded the finishes, expanded the colors, so they've made this line even better, and so it's like the best cream blush. That's a big statement. I don't want to say that, actually, but Nude Sticks specializes in cream blush, and it really is their best product still. One Size. I have a unique take on their best product, but every event that I want to wear a red lip for, One Size has the best, longest lasting, but still pretty comfortable liquid lipstick formulation. Now, my most used shade is the red shade. These are the Lip Snatchers. One Side's a liquid lipstick, One Side is a gloss. They have other colors. Every time I wear this product, my lips look the same at the end of the event that it did at the beginning. That's with eating, that's with drinking, that's with talking. I don't understand the magic behind the longevity in this product. It really, I feel like, also defies the laws of like living. How does this stay on my lips? I love a good longwear lip product, but at some point they all fade away if I'm eating, drinking, talking for a few hours. This lasts Christmas, this lasts beauty events, this lasts all day. I don't get it. And not enough people are talking about it. If I need a longwear product, this one is an amazing one. Also, the red is such a pretty blue-based red, by the way. It's gorgeous. Pat McGrath. I'm staying the same. First of all, I mean, Pat McGrath has a lot of amazing products in her range, but if you're gonna get one, you have to get a Mothership palette, particularly her original earlier ones. Those ones are the best ones where the color stories are definitely more curated, more thought out. I think that the best, most versatile one is going to be Bronze Seduction, though I will say go with whatever color story floats your boat more, but I do think that the most versatile for most people is going to be the Bronze Seduction. So what makes these palettes special? First of all, the hefty, exclusive luxury packaging. Second of all, we have her Blitz Astral shades, extremely unique to the brand. Nobody at Sephora can replicate a finish quite like Pat McGrath, and also just how unique the color stories are, but how surprisingly wearable and versatile that they are. And I'm talking about the earlier ones. Divine Rose is another great one to go to. The first one's a great one to go to. Just take a look at what you have, look at the options, but I would say, generally speaking, Bronze Seduction is an amazing one to start with. This is an extremely luxury purchase, but I do think, especially with these motherships, you are getting that worthwhile luxury experience with these. I'm biased, but I've been saying that since the beginning. Patrick Ta, this one's gonna be a hot take, because yes, his blushes are amazing, but you know what I use the most from this brand? Their mascara. I don't know. I love this mascara so much. I feel like it has a soft look to my lash, but it's still really full and volumizing. I wear this for events. It's also really, really black. It's the best product from the brand because it's the most used product that I have from the brand. Like, I use this all the time, but I use it for special events. That's how I know I love this mascara. So my favorite product is their mascara, which is not going to be the general public's take on this. But that, I'm just saying, their blushes are also amazing though. Rephr has really come out with these unique products, but I really, really love the brow sculpt. You do need to replace this quite often if you're using it quite often because it can get nasty. But this is one of the most heavy duty brow lamination gels on the market. It's so heavy duty, you can get such a good sculpt in that I literally don't even need to fill in my brows when I use this because every single brow gets put into place with this, but it's very heavy duty. I mean, your brows are literally plastered to your face with this product, so be careful, but sometimes I like that, and they do a killer job with this. I've literally lost all natural daylight. Haven't I? I think so. But we're getting towards the end. There's just a few more brands. Next one is also a really good brow gel. I think this one is rising to be my number one favorite brow gel, at least of late. This is Rare Beauty's product. It's their flexible lifting gel, which when they launched this, they said was going to be limited edition, which is such a weird product to make limited edition. I hope they don't say that anymore, because this brow gel, it's definitely less heavy duty than the Rephr, but it still places the brows exactly where you want them to go. I feel like it separates the brows, and this is another product where I don't have to fill in as much. I did fill in a little bit, but I learned my new technique. I used this brow gel to brush it out first. I let it dry, and then I barely need to line. Like, I just did a little bit here, and a little bit at the tail, a little bit at the arch, and pretty much the whole brow. And then a few strokes up. Very minimal brow work needs to be done after I use this, so it's incredible, and it lasts all day, and it's not too crunchy. It doesn't get dandruffy like the Too Faced one can. So I'm starting to like this one better than even the Too Faced. Rose Ink. I'm not like super well versed in the brand, but I do know that they have a really nice cheek color cream blush formulation. Nothing groundbreaking, but the aesthetic of the brand is really nice. The colors are very neutral, very wearable. They're gonna go with a lot of different looks. You know, the clean girl aesthetic is in. This, my packaging just broke. okay. Anyways, my mirror just fell out, but anyways, they give that clean girl aesthetic. It's a little bit more of a softer, powderish kind of feel to it. There is a glow, but it's almost like putty-like a little bit. It's a really nice formula, and the colors, I feel like, are really natural, which is really nice. Say? Are we at Say already? I guess. Yeah, okay, Say. Easily, they're a glowy super gel. This is one of my all-time favorite glowy primers. It just gives like a wet look to the face that is not overwhelming, and it's perfect for underneath any foundations because it's going to make your skin glow. It's really, really unique. There's not a lot of primers that have a finish quite like this. So if you're looking for a glowy primer, that one is definitely, definitely the way to go. And you can also put it on top of foundation to give you that glow. Sephora collection. I have not been able to put down their Rouge Gel Lip Liners. These have a very nice lasting time. They have an unimaginable color range. Like every color you can think of, they have in their range. And it is a very hydrating formula. So much so that I actually almost use these as lipsticks. I'll use them to line my lips and then I'll fill in with them. And they have a really hydrated look to the lip considering that they are a lip liner, which normally isn't the way that I go with lip liners. But something about this, I just love the ease of use. I love filling in my whole lips with these. I love all the colors that they offer. In today's look, I'm wearing the shade Nothing But Nude. I've had this on for a few hours now. Nothing's faded. It's gorgeous. Love this formula. Smashbox. An oldie but a goodie. Smashbox Primerizer.
What?
Smashbox Primerizer. If you're gonna go Smashbox, you're gonna go for the face primers. They have like so many for every skin concern. I have dry skin. I love Thrive with their Photo Finish Primerizer. This is simply just a hydrating primer, but it's really thin, so it soaks in quickly, so you don't have to wait too long for it, and it also doesn't fight with makeup because it's so thin. Just a great quench of hydration for your skin if you have dry skin before makeup. So I do love this one, and I've loved it for many, many years. Stila. I'm not into Stila nowadays. I would say if you wanted something, go with their Stay All Day Liquid Liner because it does stay all day and it's very, very black. But would I really recommend anything from Stila right now? Probably not. Tarte. This is not loved enough, but it is the best eyeliner I've ever used, period. Double Take Awake. Has to be Double Take Awake because one side is a liquid liner, which is super teeny tiny, almost like the Tom Ford. It's a great dupe for that. Very black, doesn't smudge. The other side, a nude pencil liner. This pencil liner is insane. It doesn't fade. I've never come across a pencil liner that has stayed so long and unaffected in the waterline, particularly in this nude shade, because you know, lighter colors, they tend to fade faster than darker colors. I know a lot of eyeliners that are like black will last in my waterline, but never nude until I came across this. Again, I've been wearing this for hours, and in the waterline, it still looks freshly applied. I don't know what Tarte put in this. I need you guys to buy this because I can never have this not exist. Because this seems like a product that they would eventually like fade out of their line. So please buy this because we can't let that happen. They need to know this is what the people want. What I want. Tom Ford, it's official. The Tom Ford foundation stick has been taken off the website. So I cannot share that with you. So we'll go with the second best option, which is their Traceless Soft Matte Concealer Stick, which is like the foundation stick, but in concealer form. It really is quite natural. I love this because it is traceless. So I will use this just on my under eyes where I have a little bit of blue and purple and blend it out, and I don't need to put any other makeup with it because it is a traceless soft look to the skin. So I use this all the time just to touch up redness. It's a really expensive concealer, but that tracelessness, in my opinion, is what makes it worth it. Too Faced, okay, this has been a long time favorite of mine, but they really do have one of the best full coverage, not too drying, very versatile concealers. This is the Born This Way Multi-Use Sculpting Concealer. It gives full coverage, but has a smooth, hydrating look to the skin. It's beautiful, not only as just concealer, but as foundation. People will buy a darker color and use it as bronzer as well. Get a really light color. I like to mix it with other products. I should get their lightest color so that I can mix with other concealers that I need to brighten them up with, because the formula is so versatile, it'll mix well with anything and make that formula better. This is one of the golden standard concealer formulas on the market, if you ask me, and I love the Big Fat Doe Foot. Tower 28, Easy Make Waves Mascara. This is, I think, my favorite mascara at Sephora right now. It's super duper separating, and it's very lifting. For those of us that have straight lashes, this gives them that lift. And you know, I have very short, sparse lashes. This builds on them beautifully and makes them look like I have some. Like, this might not look impressive to you, but I'm telling you, the fact that you can see my lashes is literally the win here. So yeah, I think right now, this is my favorite mascara. I know I mentioned the Patrick Ta one, and that one is like my go-to for events, but I think I like this one better. Just an FYI. Urban Decay, the all-nighter makeup setting spray. This is the golden standard for a long wear setting spray. You know I love my Charlotte Tilbury, but Urban Decay never does me wrong. I feel like a lot of long wear setting sprays, they feel like alcohol on my skin. I can feel them drying me out. Sometimes it's like applying hairspray. This does not offend me in any way, and it really does make my makeup last a long time. This is a cult classic, and it's been for many, many years from Urban Decay, but there really is a reason for that. I feel like Valentino Beauty is so stupid expensive for no reason. I do realize they're a luxury brand, but I just feel like it's just stupid expensive for the products. Like, sometimes the products are also like quite as stupid as they are expensive. But I really like their foundation. So this is the Very Valentino Light Lasting Perfecting Foundation. It has a really smooth look to the skin, similar to the smooth look that the KVD gives me, but a little bit more wearable and also more hydrating. It's more of a wet formula comparing it to the KVD foundation. Every time I wear this, I also feel like I have a really great skin day, and that says enough to me. Generally speaking, the brand, do I really recommend it? It's not one of my go-tos, honestly, not one that I would push you towards. But if you want that Valentino packaging, which they do a very nice job with, the foundation is really, really nice. I think it's one of the few products that's worth the money in the line. Westman Atelier, also another brand where I'm like, do you need to go with Westman Atelier? No. But if you're like, Morgan, I want to buy Westman Atelier, they do have a really nice bronzer stick. It's called the Face Trace Contour Stick. It's a really nice gray contour color if you're similar to my skin tone. But again, like, I wouldn't direct you to Westman Atelier. But wait, look. It's really nice magnetic closure. But I wouldn't be like, you need to spend an arm and a leg for this product, because Nude Sticks has a great contour stick. Makeup by Mario, like I said. There's a lot of other brands that do it, like Westman Atelier, but this is my favorite product from them. It's not saying much. Good brand, but very expensive, you know? I'm thinking holistically of what else you can get. Lastly, last brand. Oh my gosh, you can tell I've been getting tired, especially since the sun's going down. YSL Beauty, my favorite product from them. You have to go lips with them. My favorite, if you like a glossy lip, is the Candy Glaze. No, that's it, right? Lipsticks, yes. Candy Glaze lipsticks. These are pretty much a lip gloss in a stick form because they give that really beautiful gloss to the lips, but they also have the most luxurious packaging. So let me tell you, a lip product, very attainable. I mean, still very expensive, but like, everybody loves a good lip product, right? So you get this luxury packaging where you're like, I'm wearing my YSL lippy. It also is just a really nice glowy formulation. It smooths over the lines of the lips. I really think that this is such a cute little luxury to have. And if you want to treat yourself to a luxury item, YSL lip glazes are the way to go. You get the nice packaging. You get the pretty formula. Definitely recommend this. Holy! 56 brands, the number one products from each brand. Boom, there we have it. Don't fight with me on these because I will fight back. I'm just kidding. I won't, but don't stress me out. These are, as of today, my number one product from each brand at Sephora. Keep an eye out because will I be doing the worst product from every brand at Sephora? Eventually, I'll get there, but we definitely wanted to start off on a positive foot here. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video and found it helpful. Okay, here's gonna be my end of video challenge for you. I don't want you to list the best product from every brand at Sephora. Those comments would be long. Give me five. Give me five brands that you're the most familiar with, have tried the most products from, and tell me their number one best product that you would recommend to a friend who's interested in purchasing from that brand. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video and found it helpful. I hope you found it entertaining. And yeah, keep an eye out for the next video. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye guys, have a good one.